Welcome to this video lesson on communicating results. After completing this, you will be able to define data communication and why it is important, figure out the do's and don'ts while creating the dashboard. Communicating results is the final step, where you present the results from your analysis to the stakeholders. You explain to them how you came to a specific conclusion and your critical findings. Most often, you need to present your findings to a non-technical audience, such as the marketing team or business executives. You need to communicate the results in a simple to understand manner, and the stakeholders should be able to chalk out an actionable plan from it. But what are the important things you need to keep in mind while communicating your results? You should know your audience and speak their language. For example, you are presenting the prediction of EPL winner to a football fan. They do not understand the statistics you have used, but they can relate to the steps you followed to decide the winner. You should focus on values and outcomes. Your stakeholder would not be interested in how you got the data, but from where you got the data. The usage of credible sources helps to build confidence in your prediction. Although the goal is to predict the winner, there might be some other critical findings that are relevant. For example, the teams with the best attack, midfield, defense, and goalkeeping. The best player for each position in the league, based on the player's skills. You should clearly communicate the important assumptions and limitations you have made. For example, to calculate the overall rating of the team, you have assumed 3-4-3-1 formation for all the teams. It's important that you communicate these to the stakeholders. It's likely that your analysis is not complete and it has some limitations. You can communicate these as something that can be done instead of something that is not done. For example, the predictions on EPL are based on players' skills. But this prediction can be improved by incorporating the recent players' performance. Do not overload with more numbers or charts. Graphs and charts seem very exciting, but if you flood them in your presentation, it might not make sense. You need to find the balance between the visualizations and the numbers you want to show. For example, the best players for each position in the league can be shown with text and numbers. Such a unified view of the data, in the form of graphs, charts, and numbers, is called a dashboard. We have used Excel to create the dashboard. You can also use different open source platforms, such as R-Shiny, Tableau, Plotly, Dash, etc. That's all for this video. In the next section, we will summarize the key learnings.